डियर स्टूडेंट्स, सी लास्ट टाइम वी कंप्लीटेड थियरी पार्ट ऑफ लेसन नंबर 10, दैट इज ग्रेविटेशन. ओके, नाउ टुडे वील स्टार्ट विद द एग्जांपल्स एंड देन वील गो फॉर द एक्सरसाइज न्यूमेरिकल्स. सी अवर एग्जांपल नंबर 9.1. ओके, सी द मास ऑफ द अर्थ and mass of the sun is given. See, mass of the earth will take ME, 6 into 10 to 24 kg. Mass of the sun, moon. Okay, here earth and the moon is given. Mass of the moon, this you can take M1, this you can take M2, 7.4. Okay, now the distance between R them is R is a distance, or you can take D also, 3.84. Now see our MK system, we have to use unit in meter, so we should convert in meter. We know very well 1 kilometer is 1000 meter. Okay, now value of G is constant. Okay, we have to calculate the gravitational force between there. Now see the formula, GMEM, or we can say GM1 M2 upon D square. See, mass of the earth we have taken M1, mass of the moon is M2. Okay, so if I substitute, okay, 6 into 10 to 24, 7.4 upon okay, so we'll get answer as 2.01. okay, so this is about exercise numeric, sorry, example number 9.1. See here, M1 is given, M2 is given, that is R distance or R is given, value of G also is given. So we can calculate the gravitational force between the earth and the moon. Now see the next example, that is example number 9.2. Yes, see, car falls off a ledge and drop to the ground in 0.5 seconds. Let us say car in 0.5 seconds. Now time is 0.5 seconds. Now see here, initial velocity is 0. G is 10 meter per second. See what is the distance covered, okay, and what is the velocity. First you have to find out the velocity, second is the distance covered. Now this is a free falling object. See, V is equal to V0 plus AT. V0 is 0 and A is equal to G. So our equation will become V is equal to G into T. Now G is 10, time is 0.5. Okay, so this is the velocity. Now secondly, we have to calculate distance covered. See, the distance covered by a free falling object is half gt square. G is 10, time is 0.5. Okay, T we can say. See, once we do not have calculator, we have to go like this. So it will be 10 by 8. Okay, that will be 1.25 meter. So here the velocity of the car once it falls off, okay, is 5 meter per second. Which formula we have used? We have used V is equal to GT, and secondly the distance covered is half GT square. So this is about the example 10.1. Okay, now see our next example, Okay. Now, see here a case of body thrown in vertically upward direction. Here is a case of body thrown in a vertically upward direction like this, with the initial velocity. Okay, let us say, now see the height attained is 10 meter. Okay, what we have to calculate? The velocity with which it was thrown, you can say u also. And secondly, the time taken to reach the maximum height. Now here the body is thrown in a vertically upward direction. We know the maximum height, the velocity will be 0. So we use the equation v is equal to v0 plus at. See here a is minus g, that is negative 10. Okay, here g is given as 9.8 meter per second square. Now at highest point the velocity will become 0. v0 we have to find out. Okay, now first we calculate the time. Okay, first we calculate the time, then it will be easy for us to obtain the values. Now see, the maximum height attained is 10 meter. Okay, g is 9.8. See our equation. V is equal to v square minus v0 square upon 2a. See here, distance or height is 10. At highest point velocity is 0. v0 or u we have to find out. Okay, so this negative sign will get cancelled. V square will be 10 into 10. Now once we solve, we'll get u value is 14 meter per second. Now see, we have to calculate the maximum time taken to reach the maximum height. So our equation is this: v is equal to v0 plus 18, highest point velocity is 0, g is minus 9.8. Okay, so if you calculate, time is 1.43 seconds. Okay, so here two things where to be find out. See, the body is thrown in a vertical upward direction with some velocity, that we have to find out. See, the maximum height attained is 10 meter. We have to calculate with what velocity it was thrown, so that we have obtained by using the equation d is v square minus v0 square upon 2a. So we'll get the initial velocity, and v is equal to v0 plus 80. So here a is my gravitational acceleration, that is minus 9.8. So we can obtain the value of time. So I told earlier also, see, the kinematic equation of motion with the uniform or constant acceleration are most important. Okay, see, whatever standard up to which or you study the physics, one or the another way it will be useful. Yeah, that's why I want you should have a lot of practice for the lesson. Okay, now this is about example number 10.3. now see our next example, that is 10.4. Okay, now see, the mass of an object is 10 kg. What is the weight on the earth? Now see, earth, on the surface of the earth, g is 9.8 meter per second square. See, the gravitational force is weight is mg, 10 into, yeah, weight is a force, so the unit of weight is newton. Okay, that is 98 newton. Now next is example number 10.5. Okay, an object whose weight 10 newton on the surface of the earth, what will be weight on the moon? See, weight W is weight. W1 is the weight on the earth, that is 10 newton. W2, okay, now weight is mg. Okay, see, the gravitational acceleration on the moon is 1.6 times gravitational acceleration of Earth. Okay, now see W is mg, so W E upon W m is equal to g E upon g. Okay, so 10, weight on the Earth is given as 10, weight on the Moon we have to find out. Okay, g E, now g m is g E by 6. Okay, so weight on Moon will be 10 upon 6. Okay, so this is how we can obtain weight on the Moon. Now remember, mass always remains same, but weight will be different at different places. See, when I talk of different places, not the our cities like Ahmedabad, Vadodara, Rajkot. So, but in that case, we have to think of the universe. In that case, we have to take different planet also, or the stars. Okay, so, or a satellite also. So that is our, we have to consider all celestial objects. Okay, so this is how we can solve example number 10.4 and 10.5. See, 10.4, mass is given, we have to obtain the value of object. So gravitational force is mg. Okay, here mass, weight on the Earth is given, weight on the Moon we have to find out. See, we know that, see, the gravitational acceleration on the Moon is 1/6 times gravitational force on the Earth. So, or sorry, gravitational acceleration on the Moon is 1/6 times that on the surface of the Earth. So by using this, we can calculate the weight on the surface of the Moon. Now see, our next example is 10.6. That is related to pressure. Now see, here a block is given. Okay, now see its dimension are 20 centimeter, 10 centimeter and 40 centimeter. See, this side is 40 centimeter. Now it is resting like this. Okay, now see the force exerted, wooden block, it is resting like this on the surface. Mass is 5 kg. F is equal to mg. What is 9 meter? Now, see, when it is resting on this Earth like this on the surface, so what is the area here? 20. Okay? Area 20 to 10. Now remember, 1 centimeter square is 10 to minus 4 meter square. So, area will be 200. Okay, now you have to calculate the pressure. Pressure is force upon area. Okay, so they can okay, pressure is force upon area. See, 49 by 2. Okay, so that is 24.5. See, this will move to the numerator, will become positive. So the pressure is Newton per meter square. Now in the second case, see, it is resting on the surface like this. See, the same block, but its position is changed. See, the 40 centimeter and 10 centimeter. Okay, so here the surface area will change. Area is will become 40 into 10, 400 cm square minus 4. Weight is mg, z we have same. Okay, so we have to calculate ratio angle when the block is resting on the surface like this. So here the 49 Newton is force will remain same, 4 into 10 to minus 2. Okay, that will be 40 into 10. Okay, so we can divide. Okay, so this is how we can solve. Now this is about the pressure is force upon area. Now see if the 40 centimeter and okay, sorry, here the time, this side is 20 centimeter. Okay, so it will be 40 into 2, 800. Okay, so value of pressure will change 49 upon 8. Okay, that turns out to be 6.12. Okay, 6.12 Newton per meter square. So, okay, by mistake I had taken surface areas like this. Okay, so in that case the pressure will change. Okay. 6.12 10 raised to 2 Newton per meter square. Okay, now, so what do you do? Consider the area on which the force acts. So force is, pressure is force upon area. Okay, force is 49 Newton, area is 800 cm square, that we are converting the meter square. So this is about example number 10.6. Now, next is example number 10.7. Okay, now the relative density of silver is 10.8. Okay, here we are given relative density of silver. Okay, what density of water? 1000 kg per meter cube. What will be the density of silver in SI unit? Now see, SI unit is this kg. SI unit of density is kg per meter cube. Okay, SI unit of the density is kg per meter cube. Now we know the relative density is the density of two material, or a density one material is water. Or whenever we divide density of a material by density of water, we get a relative density. So here we use same thing, relative density of silver. Now see, rho s is the density of silver, rho s upon rho w. Okay, rho s is the density of silver, rho w is the density of water. See, that is given to us is a 10 raised to 3 kg per meter cube or 1000 kg per meter cube. Now relative density is given 10.7. Rho s we have to find out. Water density is 10 raised to 3 kg per meter cube or 1000. So rho s is 10.7. Okay. Now remember, kg per meter cube is a SI unit, okay, of relative density. So this is how we can obtain value of density of silver. Okay, with that we have completed examples of lesson number 10, that is gravitation. Now we start exercise numericals. See, some of that are theoretical that we'll discuss in the classroom. Okay. Now Okay. Now, see, question is, first question, how do the gravitational force between two objects changes with distance? Changes to half. See, initial distance is okay, then the force is, let us say, F1. When distance between object change to half, that is d by 2, force we have to find out. Let us say F1 is F, F2 we have to find out. Now see the gravitational force F, G, M1, M2. See F varies 1 upon d square, that is following inverse square law. Okay? That is following inverse square law. Now, so here F1 is F, F2 we have to find out. So we can say F1 upon F2 is D2 square upon D1 square. F1 is F, F2 we have to find out. Okay, now distance is changed to D by 2. Okay, so F2 will become 4F. Okay, so gravitational force will become 4 times initial force. If the distance between the object, between two objects is changed to half of the initial distance, the force will become 4 times. Okay, now let us say what happens if the distance is changed to 2D. Okay, what happens if the distance between them changes to 2D? Here also we have to use the same phenomena, same question. So F1 upon F2 is d2 square upon d1 square. F1 is f, d2 is has become 2d now. Okay, so we can solve. Okay, so f2 will become f5. Okay, so if the distance between them is changed to 2d, the force will be f by 4. Okay, that will be 1 upon 4 times initial force. So this is how we can say, we can see that the gravitational force between two objects, okay, follows inverse square law. Okay. See, next is exercise number 10.2. Gravitational force acts on all objects proportional to their masses. Why then a heavy object do not fall faster than? Okay, example of a heavier object. Heavier object, let us say elephant. Okay, now see, compared to the earth. Okay. Now F is equal to GME M upon D. Okay. Now see F upon M. Here M may be heavier object, let us say elephant, and M may be a lighter object, let us say an ant. Now see the gravitational acceleration is GME upon D square. So F upon M is G is the gravitational acceleration. Here D is nothing but R is the radius of the earth. So if I substitute this, so on the surface of the earth, see the gravitational force acceleration G, that is independent of the mass. That is independent of the mass. So for the all object, see the value of the gravitational acceleration is same. So that's why for both objects, let us say lighter or heavier object like an elephant or an ant like a lighter object, see the value of the gravitational acceleration remain the same. So that's why, see the heavier object do not fall with a larger velocity. Okay? Do not fall with a larger velocity. So this is about, see the exercise number 10.2. The question says the gravitational force acts on proportional to their masses. Yes, it does varies proportional to masses, but this is the gravitational force, sorry, gravitational acceleration is independent of the mass of the object. That depend on the mass of the object which produces the gravitational force. That is a source. Here the source is Earth. Okay, and see, the gravitational acceleration is independent of the mass on which the force acts. Okay, that's why, see, the value of the gravitational acceleration is same for a lighter object or maybe the heavier object. Okay, now next is exercise sum number 10.3. Okay, see, what is the magnitude of the gravitational force between a 1 kg earth okay distance is on the surface 6.4 okay. Now see, when we consider the distance, we have to consider center to center distance. So in that case, we can obtain the value of the gravitational force. Okay, so this is how we have to obtain the value of the gravitational force. Now see here, value of capital G is 6.67 okay, newton meter square upon kg. So here m1 is m e, m2 is 1 kg, the distance between them. Okay, now see our formula. See, the gravitational force F is equal to G m1 m2 upon r. Okay, 6.67, m1 is m e, 6 into 10 to 24, yes, r. Now if you solve, this turns out to be 9.8 newton. Okay, and see, if I divide 9.8 newton by the mass of the object, see, that is a value of the gravitational acceleration. So this is how, see, if the 1 kg mass, okay, see, we can consider here also, this is a center and this is a distance, but just to show the separate object, I have taken m1 and m2 as a separate object, and the distance is short. So the force, gravitational force between two objects, G is equal to M1, F is equal to G M1 M2 upon R square. So force will get a 9.8 newton. So this is about the some of the exercise numericals of lesson number 10. See, today we have completed examples of lesson number 10 and we have taken some of the exercise numericals also. See, next time we'll proceed further. Thank you.